Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, this is Bastard Slot, and welcome back, finally, to Planet Zoo. Today, we're going to start work, as promised, on our Australian zoo. I decided against the Mega Zoo just because lag and stuff like that, but we never really built an Australian zoo. I've never built a koala habitat, I've never built a kangaroo habitat, etc. So, that's what we're going to do today, and just like you may have seen in my expertly drawn video, with the notepad, our little low-budget Planet Zoo we did when my PC was dead. We're gonna do, essentially, a treetop village platform wood thingamajiggy kind of shebang. I will say, straight off the bat, this was the hardest exhibit I've ever had to build. Now, there's two reasons for that. The first is the general layout is difficult to work with. It just is. The idea is that the koalas essentially live on the path. It's going to be a walkthrough habitat. What I'm doing here is building the platforms. The idea was that there'd be all these platforms kind of hanging from the trees, and the koalas would move from platform to platform, which sounds easy, but in reality, the koalas are a massive, massive pain in the ass. They do not climb anything. They hate climbing things. It's very, very difficult to get them to move across a platform. So I spent probably about an hour that you don't see in this video just working on sorting these platforms out. It ends up definitely messier than I would have liked, but it was the only way to make it work, basically. So just building the little platform here, stringing up some rope around it. The idea, of course, you know, I don't want it to just float. It's not a magical platform. It's a koala platform. And the ropes kind of meet in the middle and they hook around the tree. And you go from there. There's our little walkthrough. Gonna end up expanding and changing the barriers later on. I didn't really have a great idea for how that was gonna work. The other side, however, is gonna be just, you know, dirt. We like to get a little dirty every now and again. This is, of course, as I mentioned in that video, going to be a cassowary habitat eventually as well. They're going to sort of join together somewhat. Not too much, not as much as I planned. I still want them to feel like individual habitats, but hey-ho. So, what am I doing here? Nobody knows. Oh, we're making a little one. We're making the baby. So I wanted to use the pallets. I want to use Australian stuff wherever possible. The pallets are an Australian item. And obviously we need a smaller one of these as well, just for use on the smaller trees, basically. Now, originally, my plan for this was to have all the trees, because as you can see, they're floating, and usually trees don't float. You know, sometimes you'll find like a magical tree and it'll float and be beautiful, but usually trees don't float in real life. So, originally the plan was to build like rock pillars underneath them all, and have all the trees standing on like these little rock pillars. In reality, I started to do that and I think it just looked stupid. So I kind of got rid of that fairly quickly. Originally, the idea was the koalas would be able to live in this lower region as well, but I changed that up pretty quickly as well. I changed up a lot when I was doing this habitat. I had an idea, but it's not like anything I've ever built before, so it kind of just, yeah, I don't know. So what we're doing here, same idea, same floating platform, but it's going to be a floating or like a strung up house kind of thing for the koalas. So what I've done is taken an Indian rug. There's not many usable small fabrics in the game, but taking an Indian rug and changed all the colours so that they're identical, so you can't see the patterning on it anymore, because obviously that wouldn't be particularly appropriate for the Australian zoo. And then we rotate it around and it makes this nice little like teepee looking thing. I think it looks really good, actually. I was really proud of how those turned out, so we're going to use a couple of those. But the idea is that's going to get strung up there, and as you walk past, you'll be able to look inside and see the koalas sleeping on their hanging tent building kind of thing. What I was doing here, I was trying to decide what rocks I'm going to use. I've used a lot of the faux rocks recently, so I thought, okay, this time we'll use the normal ones. I was thinking maybe we could use both. You know, I was editing the faux rock so it looks like the red Australian rock, but we're in Australia, never built an Australian zoo before. Why not use the actual Australian rocks was the idea by the end. And we're going to start building actual tall bits of ground for the trees to sit on, and trying to make it so that the platform's a little higher up, because if the platform is sitting attached to the tree but then the ground is about an inch below, it's not very impressive. An inch isn't very impressive. We need a little bit more than that. I was originally going to do a waterfall. You'll see me mess around with that in a second as well, but that didn't really work out. Got to change my settings. First time I've played Planet Zoo since the new PC. Yeah, it's going to try for a waterfall, but it doesn't suit the environment. It pulls focus away from the important areas. I'll do something with waterfall eventually because waterfalls are cool, but this is not the time, I don't think. But I enjoyed this. I got to do... Well, I didn't enjoy this. This bit was fun. Later on was not fun. We'll talk about that. This bit I got to do a lot of terrain work, which is something I've not been able to do for quite a long time. We didn't really do any in the aquatic park, and it tends to be the stuff that I'm good at, so that was fun. I really wanted this one, this hanging tent, to be hanging from a tree, but in like a very sort of in a different sort of way. So I got rid of the rope in the middle and attached like a thick rope. You'll see, it's only one there, but we're gonna thicken that up. So it's kind of like when you go on holiday to the Brazilian rainforest, you know, as you do, and you have a tent that hangs off the ground, and you like rope it to a tree, so you know, it keeps you away from the insects and stuff like that. Same idea, really. And they look pretty cool. No, there goes a waterfall. But the idea, so the story, there's not much of like a story by my standards, but the general story of the environment is that it's kind of, I mentioned something a little bit like this before, but it's kind of like this valley, essentially. And it's a valley of very dry rock, as you can see I'm painting it there in this sort of dry rock colours. But it's formed, you know, because it's like a pit in this sort of dry rock valley, it forms like a little oasis sort of thing. So I really liked the contrast between this sort of dry exterior, and then the inside's going to have quite a lot of plant life, quite a lot of water and stuff like that. And none of the animals are going to go down there anyway. Which took bloody ages to figure out, by the way. Just to make it so the koalas would not venture down into the bottom part of this habitat, it took freaking ages. Like I said, I probably cut an hour to an hour and a half out of this video because it was just me just trying to make things work rather than building things. It just wasn't very interesting. As exciting as this is right now, obviously. I really like these gum trees. They're very cool. They're very... like that bright white trunk is pretty original. It's pretty sweet. Well done, gum tree. Important to mix and match the rock with the green grass. As I say, I wanted to emphasize that kind of oasis kind of nature, and the koalas have formed like a, I don't know, just like a little family unit that thrives in this hidden little cavern, cove, what do I call it? Canyon? I think I called this place Koala Canyon. Canyon spelled with a K, obviously. You know, that's science, don't argue with science. So this was problem numero uno. There were two main problems. One was the koalas themselves, because I hate koalas officially now, but the other problem was getting my staff members into the habitat. Because as I say, they have to get onto the path. Now, this is a walkthrough habitat, as in, you know, guests can walk in and out and walk through the entire thing. For whatever reason, staff can't use those doorways, and I don't know why I struggled so much with this. I will figure it out eventually, I promise, but it takes me a little bit of time. So initially, I put all the staff to the side, trying to figure that out, trying to connect these two together, which doesn't work. Oh no, it does. It worked eventually. But the problem is they get in and then they're at the bottom of the habitat, right? They're not up on the path. So I thought, okay, what I'll do is I'll put a path on the other side. But you can't have a path coming out of both sides of a staff door. It doesn't work. Because the idea is that one half's in the habitat and they don't think you want to put path in the habitat. Even though I would have liked to put path in the habitat. So here, I brought the koalas in. Figuring out where they could go and stuff like that. And really this is where most of the cutting has occurred. Because the goal was to make it so they could explore everything. The entire path area. And also navigate from platform to platform. So you'll see me try and get lots of different ramps. Lots of different pieces of wood. Lots of different poles. Anything that exists, essentially, to try and let my koalas climb up onto these bloody platforms. I tried everything possible, every single thing possible. Koalas hate climbing. For an arboreal creature, they hate trees. They are the most anti-tree. It's like they're just self-hating, you know? Like, oh, I hate my life in the bloody trees. I'm gonna live on the ground. That'll show them. I did figure it out eventually. It ends up much messier than I would have liked. The idea when I kind of planned this in my head was to have like thin logs stretching between all the habitats, and they'd be over the top of your head, and you know, it'd be quite subtle. It'd look really cool. It just doesn't work. The koalas will not climb the logs, basically. It drove me insane. I nearly quit here. This was about the point where I was gonna just give up on the idea, give up on all the work I'd done at this point, which at this point is about 2 hours worth. And I was just going to delete it. I finally managed to get one up there. You can see how the path blocks it, so we do have to get rid of the path boundary as well, like the fencing. But just getting them up onto one wasn't enough. Like, it just, the challenge just kept going. Just constantly, they'd be unable to climb any further. It drove me insane. I had to get rid of a lot of the rope and stuff at the sides. So that's okay. There we go. See, so it's just constantly removing things, moving things by a little inch to see if it helps. And then going back into the heat map mode to see if the things can bloody climb. My ears itchy. It's not quite done, I would say, at this point. I have just realised this, but a lot of these pathways I'm building need a supporting structure or some description, so we'll have to go back and add that at the end of the time-lapse. But generally speaking, just, yeah, for some reason they couldn't get over here. I mean, why can't you climb that? Why I could walk that, and you are an arboreal climbing animal. Why can't you climb? I don't understand. And it's funny, I tweeted about this last night when I finally finished the video. I sent out a tweet out saying, right, I hate koalas now, basically. And somebody responded, oh, yeah, would they not climb for you either? Basically, someone knew exactly what I was talking about without me even saying what had happened, because clearly this is a problem with the koalas, because they're stupid. But we did get there eventually. It ended up looking a little bit messy, but a little bit Lionel, as the cool kids say. Okay, as I say, I'm not a cool kid, but that's neither here nor there. But I really wanted this to feel like they were all connected together, you know, like the whole platform system was interconnected. So constantly I was adding new pathways and trying to make it work so that the koalas could actually climb up. It was just insane, folks. It makes me sad just watching it back. It does end up very cool. I would say this is definitely, nice to say, the hardest work habitat I've ever done, but it is probably one of the more unique ones as well. I have never built anything like this before. I don't really do climbing mechanics, do you know me? I do miss the water already, though. It was nice building with water. Water looks dramatic, and it might be one of the reasons I flooded the ground here. Because I like open expanses of water look okay to me. Open expanses of ground, a little bit less so. And, you know, we're in Australia, so there's going to be, like, wide open plains and stuff like that. Could not for the life of me figure out why the koala couldn't climb on this bloody ramp. What's wrong with it? I thought, oh, maybe the tree's blocking it, but it's not. And it can walk past, so clearly it could climb up. It's just a nice-looking slope, and the koala can't climb the bloody thing. I hate koalas. They're the worst, right. So, at this point, I was trying to fix my staff problem. I fired all my staff, I should have, and this weren't working for me. Well, now they're literally not working for me. I realised what I should do instead is not be an idiot. I thought that was a much better idea. So what we're going to do is we're going to have a second door right at the start of the habitat, get rid of the fencing on the path at the bottom, and then basically the staff member is going to walk in, walk along some dirt, walk onto the path, and then enter the habitat. Basically, there we go. So at this point we were in pretty good stead. The koalas can climb on absolutely everything. It's more a case now of doing detail work, lots of rocks as well to give it that canyon kind of feel, and also because I've got these spaces, as you can see, wherein there's gaps in the fence because I need the koalas to be able to climb over. And of course, if you get rid of the fence on the path, it gets rid of it from both sides. So I went back and added it again in some places. I was going to try this Australian sort of sedimentary rock thing, but it looks stupid, so I didn't. Basically, my nose is very snuffly. I need to snuffle. I snuffled. I'm sorry. Shush, girl. You're very loud. Right. That's my PC, by the way, before anyone gets excited. So lots of, like, tall rock pillars, which is kind of, like, you know, big red rock pillars and flat expanses, and that's kind of what I associate largely with a lot of Australia anyway. Koalas do live in some more tropical environments as well as more like grassland drier environments as well. They've got a nice mix there, so I thought this was a nice way to combine the two. It's got like a little bit of an Ewok village vibe. It's why I've added another house as well. I figured the platforms alone aren't that exciting, but the houses are pretty cool. I was really happy with how the design looks. This one, because there's no trees in the area and there's no way there can be a tree in an area like that, I'm just gonna supplement with rocks. But with the rocks, it's important they all feel interconnected as well, so they're supported and physically they make sense. And yeah, the koalas are actually pretty happy. The only problem they have is the terrain, and I can't fix that because it's, I think with stuff like this, the terrain's set when you put the path down. I did try to change the terrain underneath to see if it would change their active terrain, but I didn't do a bloody thing, so. Anyways, a little bit of grass work. I became obsessed with the wattle brush. Everyone knows who watches my series, one of my favourite things to do in all of life, not just in Planet Zoo, is to have a bush. Is to have like a bush peeking out from like within the cracks of the rocks, right? I love doing it. I think it looks really good. It makes me happy every time. So obviously we're gonna do that. Wattle brush, bush. I tell you, wattle bush is our bush of choice for today, and is one of my favorites. It's got this really nice, craggy, dry sort of look to it that really suits what I was going for. Nice dry bush. It ended up really good, actually. I ended up really happy with it, especially because I had to work at it. You know, this took effort. It really did. But it kind of came together. There's a lot of open space. Like, it's funny because a lot of the time spent on this habitat was not spent on where the koalas live. It's spent on the surrounding area where they don't even go, like down here. But it's just so as you walk past, you feel like you're in a natural place, basically. I wanted it to feel like you're in this natural environment and the koalas have chosen. I mean, doesn't it look good there? I'm actually really proud of this, the more I think about it. Did a lot of work just making the environment feel natural, which is different than the last park, to say the least. Thought I'd put some of the enrichment items actually on the path, so in theory, the koalas should go and use the enrichment items as the guests walk past them, which I thought was nice. In reality, the koalas would eat the guests, but that's okay. Koala Canyon, there. I might change that because it does upset me deeply, but that's the plan for now. I really wish, we've got this sign, look at that sign there, right? You've got the sign, it's clearly two pieces of metal, and yet you can't put the text on the lower half of the metal, it has to sit on the top. And I don't get, why is it designed like that? Why are the signs in this game so weirdly designed? They'll be massive and the text will only take up like a fifth of the bloody thing. It's very silly, okay? Anyway, time for lighting. As promised, I will retain my focus on lighting. I want my zoos to look as good in the daytime as they do at nighttime. Vice versa. Actually better at nighttime, if anything. I'm going to use the Australian lampposts. They're a little bit gimmicky for my liking, a little bit gauche. How do I not sound pretentious when I say gauche? I think that might be the first time I've ever said the word gauche on this channel. There you go. They're a little bit gauche for my liking, but they're really tall and they bend, which means I can put them in, not those ones, that's annoying, but I can put them in sort of interesting locations. They're not all just sitting on the path. Some of them sit on the dirt, some of them sit on the rocks, etc, etc. I have a little platforms with a little mirror mobile, and outcome, I've got my themes now, and one of my themes is spotlights, clearly, with slightly different colours as well. So I just wanted to heat up, or light up, the areas where the koalas are going to be active, but with more sort of warm colourings, and of course we have to block in some of these gaps as well. And it's just nice to have two different colours rolling, it just makes things a little bit more interesting, and I felt like the red light was a little bit warmer, nicer for the koalas to experience, essentially. Like so. Lovely stuff. Very sexy. Yes. Put some pallets on the ground, no idea why. That's as far as it went. I do want that over here. I kind of wanted to make a face and then kind of wanted to cover it in dots, and it kind of looks like it's chicken pox, so I got rid of that pretty quickly. A little sign here saying shh, because this is a, you know, it's a koala sleeping area. You're meant to be respectful as you go through here. The koala's going to be playing around, but they're also going to be asleep. They need their beauty sleep. You know, be quiet, be chill, be chill. We're near the end now, I think. Oh, very near the end. Oh, cheeky. 5 seconds away. Just doing what I always do there, as you can see, surrounding the outskirts of the habitat with trees. Again, I'm going to highly recommend this as a practice. I think if you check most YouTubers who play this game, they'll do this. Maybe not on a exhibit-by-exhibit basis. For me, it kind of works because I'm only building small, very habitat-focused zoos. But if you're building a big zoo, or indeed a little zoo like this, it helps to surround things with trees. It gives things a real sense of scale. and distance and makes them feel like they're part of something bigger. I really, really recommend it. Plus, I love trees. Okay, so we're going to go hop in-game. I need to ship in, like, 20 more koalas. And, yeah, I'll show you it in-game. See you in a sec. Right then, folks, here we go. I'll do a little tour first of all, so you can see it nice and slowed down. So here is our entrance. Needs maybe a little bit more work. It needs a tree here, I think. Let's put a tree there, shall we? No, we'll do the tour first. Don't get distracted. So, walk through habitat. There's our little koala. The misspelling, I can't get over it. And there's, if you missed him, our little koala lamp up there as well, because he's adorable. So you head inside. There's a nice view of the whole thing. As you can see, there is a staff entrance over here on the right, and then I've blocked everything in. Put another rock there. So the idea is simply the staff walks in, and they can't go anywhere else. And the koalas can come down here, but they also can't climb out. They can't do... Actually, they might be able to climb out of this now, because I changed this to wood since I last checked. But the point is the koalas shouldn't be able to get out. So they're really just going to spend all their time up here. Tell you what, I think this is one of those habitats where we have to walk it to properly experience it, right? A leader, my dear, you are now Tejid Cam, which is a much more beautiful name, I think you'll agree. Okay, let's head inside. Here we go. Oh, we pop. I really like this, actually. I really wasn't convinced at first, but yeah, it's growing on me a lot. It's a labor of love, I tell you. What are you doing, you silly koala? There we go. Hello, buddy. So, I don't love this, I've got to be honest. My original vision for it was a lot cleaner than this. I don't want my guests to be able to walk up onto these platforms, but... It's that or nothing, honestly. Like, it's necessary. I might have to put some rocks at the sides here so people don't... What are you doing over there? Come here. There we go. Hey, buddy. You are super cute. You're a pain in the ass, but you are super cute. Hey, what's your name? This is Willow. Oh, Willow's home! We're gonna get peppers! Oh, very cool. Very cool. Alright, let's carry on. So, there's my little shush sign. And there's our... Again, you can walk in. Again, there's nothing I can do about it. The only alternative is to have all the platforms hanging completely different heights. But I like the idea of the koalas walking around on the path, so I can't really have best of both worlds, so we're just gonna get over it, basically. I really like it here. It's not something I would usually build, and that makes me happy. Same thing over here, not ideal. I didn't actually notice this, I'll have to block that off as well. Oh, where did you go? But you can get under there, it's fun for the kids. I'll put some rocks in and stuff and kind of block these paths up a little bit more. Hello, buddy. See, that's nice. I think it would have to be like a private tour. You can't have tons of people walking through here at once. It would have to be... What I'm going to do is I'm going to build a sign with, like, show times, and it would be a guided tour once every hour to, A, not overly disturb the koalas, but to make sure people are nice and respectful to koalas as well. I think that's important. So I will do that for sure. Little glimpse at the rest of the habitat. It's just, you know, we've always kind of seen it. Walk around here, and then we can head upwards further into the trees. The whole idea behind building the bottom of the habitat so rugged and uppy-downy and covered in rocks and everything was to... make it feel like you are in the treetops constantly, even though the tree is technically, you know, standing on a piece of rock. It should feel like you're constantly in the treetops, and I think it kind of works. Head over here. I've got a couple of lights over here for this hanging house here. Another shush sign. There's our thingamajiggy. Here, look at it. Look. So I don't know if you actually saw that enough in the video, but it's a strangler fig tree. It's the only tropical plant I have, which isn't great, but because of the way it curves, it was perfect. And the whole thing is just sort of strung up on top of it. It looks haphazard, I won't lie, but you know, I'm willing to go with that. But yeah, that's about it, folks. That is our treetop Ewok koala village. There you go, nice little view of the whole thing. I really like it. It needs a little tuning up here and there, but honestly, I've put in so much time that the idea of doing anything else kind of killed me. So, yeah, nothing special with the lighting here. Wanted all the lights to be at the top, so none of the lights are down here at the bottom, of course. And there they go. Who have we got here? This is Willow again, who's going to have babies... Oh god, 3 years away? Oh, that's because my timing is set to... Yeah, okay, that makes sense. There's Logan. Oh, someone else over there. And Benjamin.
Or Chad. Yeah, and I'll just prove that they can actually... So if I grab hold of Benji here, this Logan, whatever, and we click on Habitat, there you go. They can get across everything. This is marked as climbing only, but that's good because they actually needed, you know, climbing stuff for their habitat. So, yeah, as you can see, they can... Bear with me, folks. How are we doing now? How are we doing? There we go. Beautiful. What about on the other one? Is that okay? Nope, we have the same problem over here. Let's just fix that nice and quickly. I hope it's rock. The rock. Rock. Eh? Eh? Wait, where the hell is it? Why aren't you working? Maybe it's not the rocks. Eh? Why dost thou hate me so much? I'll fix it. It's fine. Anyways, that is our Koala Canyon habitat. I think that's about it. So, yeah, we'll see the babies in a future video as time sort of naturally passes and stuff like that. But that is the first habitat of our brand new Australian zoo. Not much else to say. If you enjoyed this video, if you appreciate the work, please do let me know in the comment section down below. Hit the like button. It really does help me out and makes me feel all warm and fuzzy inside. Why are you all hanging out on this one platform? God will never know. Stop pooping. My one concern as well is they're going to poop on the platform, as you can see, and then my zookeepers won't be able to get onto the platform. Well, there you go. See, all this kind of stuff is messier than I would like, but I just... It was necessary at the end of the day. I'd rather them be able to use the habitat and for it to function how it was designed to function and it be a little bit messy than to just not work at all. Hello! Who have we got here? Emily again. Adorable. Right, folks. Right, left. Good stuff. I'm tired now. Like I said, this is kind of what I mean. I need some, like, poles under here. There's a little bit of tidy-up work to do, but nothing major at all. Nothing major at all. Who's this? Isabella. Yeah, good. Oh, it's charging. Who is it? On the run. The Formiga train. Well, these three are forming a train. This one has absolutely... Cotton crap it. Lachlan. Lachlan has no interest in the train. He was desperate to come and sit over here before anyone else does. This is primo koala sitting spots, you see, and Lachlan had to get there first. Aww. Could mess around the time of day as well to bring a bit more light into this area, stuff like that. Right, yes, sorry, I'll stop wasting your time. We'll end it there. Thank you so much for joining me. If you are excited about the series, I do have a playlist for it down below. Check that out. You can follow the playlist along. Remember to subscribe for more videos. It's not going to be daily like it was with the Aquatic Park, but my goal right now is to try to do it twice a week. You know, they do take a long time, blah, 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 but I figure twice a week should be more than doable. Next video then, the cassowaries. Very exciting. Cassowaries, and then saltwater crocodile, and then... Kangaroo and Dingo is my current plan. Right, I'm gonna go. Thank you so much for joining me. I'll see you lovely folks next time. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye.